space, the boundary of human achievement, the new frontier.
It's just a cough.
Yeah, right. And the earth is flat.
Treat your cough seriously with Robitussin CF Max. Nothing lasts longer and treats more symptoms for your cough, cold, and flu. Robitussin, because it's never just a cough.
In a few moments, you will have an experience which will seem completely real. It will be the result of your subconscious fears transformed to your conscious awareness. Warning, this tape must not be played by government personnel. It can be extremely harmful and result in severe trauma. You have 5 seconds to terminate this tape. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hold him. Now you listen to me, you hillbilly punk who thinks the world's still round. I'm here to tell you it's not. It's flat.
Lexi, tell us something interesting.
Okay. The earth is flat, and a witch stole his pants.
Flat Earth expert Mark Sargent thinks the moon landing was a hoax.
Technically, the moon itself is a hoax.
Right, but betting with Sportsbet's new iPhone app?
I could do this standing on my head.
Thanks, gravity. Sportsbet's new iPhone app. It's foolproof.
Hold on. I know how we're different. Do you believe the Earth is flat?
I know it's flat. I walk on it.
Holy shit.
The Earth is flat.
It's a flat world after all.
Smoke weed every day. Hold up. Smoke weed every day. Hold up. Smoke weed every day. Hold up.
Smoke weed every day. Hold up. Und jetzt der Verkehr. Vorsicht, liebe Autofahrer, auf der A3 Oberhausen Richtung Arnheim ist die linke Spur aufgrund eines UFO-Absturzes gesperrt.
Broadcasting straight to you from a large spaceship currently at war with mainstream science. Meanwhile, the Peanut Gallery has only one thing to say on this day. It's not the voting that's democracy. It's the counting. Actually, it's pretty good. Did you steal that? I think you stole that. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Strange World, where the truth is often stranger than fiction. I'm your host, Mark Sargent, creator of Flat Earth Clues, which propose that all of us are living inside a Truman Show enclosed structure thousands of miles wide. Just Google Flat Earth Clues. If you can't find it, well, you suck at the internet. Currently, the show is on Tuesday nights at 7 Pacific, 10 Eastern. And yes, Caroline, if it is not Election Day, November 8th, 2022, then you are listening to a rerun. Quote of the day goes exactly like this one thing. I have never voted for anything ever. Voting in this world is just another illusion of choice. Who said that? Me. Just now. My co-host, she's lovely, she's sassy, and she's one of the biggest flat earth rock stars ever, Karen B. Hey, Karen, what's going on?
Hey, Mark, what's going on?
Are you now fully relaxed now that you're out of conference mode and you're kind of back and, you know, getting ready for the end of the year?
Yes, yes.
You look good. You look rested.
I feel better now. I feel like I'm finally over it.
Nice, nice.
On to the next.
Yes. Hey, Karen, being the current queen of Flat Earth, it must be hard to find Flat Earth friends other than Ted. Do you know an easy way to find cool people like yourself and solid info about our stationary horizontal level plane?
Why, yes. That would be the Flat Earth Sun, Moon, and Zodiac Clock app.
Yes, indeed. It's the perfect gift for friends, family, and complete strangers. Watch the featured video every day for 2 weeks and see what happens. It'll be the best $2.99 you've ever spent. I'm so tired. I have slept like crap. There's a windstorm, just so you guys didn't know. I mean, you can look it up. Just hit the Northwest, and this island in particular just came down and just hammered, just clobbered us. Bam, 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 bam. Knocked down all the trees, all the power lines. In fact, it got so bad that water service was starting to, that required electric pumps, was starting to flag. So, yeah, I've been a little frazzled, but that's okay. Don't forget, you can also find this program on BitChute and Brighteon, on Rockfin and Rumble. YouTube is not the end of Flat Earth. It's just the beginning. Shout outs to Flat Earther Stephen Carpenter of the Deftones and Karen's Hat. Support the Flat Earth cause and get the coolest hoodies ever and hat. Wait, can you buy those hats? Or is that custom?
Yeah, but this is from Deftones, not from the Strong family.
Oh, okay. All right. Just go to the strong.family to get your super cool merch. Also, truthsmacks.com. Spreading truth, one delicious bite at a time. Truthsmacks, Trail Mix Supreme. Lots of good stuff in here.
Best trail mix ever.
Yes, it is. Karen's got her bag.
I'm a fan of the mint.
Yeah. Mm. Also, shout out to Bolton family because they sponsored my trip out to the conference with their curbside cookery. Mm, Bolton's. Yeah. Nice. Are we still doing the commercial tonight?
Yes, the Bolton's commercial.
Yay! Cool. Let me know. Let me know when you get tired of that. You haven't gotten tired of my Truth Smacks one, so I don't know how you get tired of the other one. Meetups.
Are you going to make me a new Truth Smacks one?
Yeah, I suppose I should make a new Truth Smacks.
We can do a new one if you want.
All right, I'll do it. I'll do it. I'll do it. I'll come up with something better. I don't know if I'll have it. I should have it done by next
week. Don't worry about it. It's not a rush. We have a commercial, but right, if you want to do a new one, we can do it.
I will come up with something for next week, I swear. Okay, meetups. Who's got the meetups? I do. Karen's probably got some meetups too. But the ones I have in my channel, there is a meetup in Minnesota, November 12th. You can check out the video for that. There is a meetup, California meetup. There's also Utah meetup November 12th and Del Mar, California, November 9th. That's tomorrow.
Yes. Oh, and Brian is hosting a meetup in Southern California.
Really?
Yes. November 16th at the Longboard Restaurant and Pub in Huntington Beach, California, 3 p.m. Pacific.
When's that?
November 16th.
Nice.
Next week.
Next week. So the Del Mar one is tomorrow. And then the Utah and Minnesota, don't you know, yada hey, those are going to be on the 12th. And then the one you just mentioned is going to be on the 16th.
Yes.
And if he wants to reach out to me,
he's got a promo up. I mean, you know.
Oh, he does?
Yeah.
Well.
You can make a promo for it too if you want.
Well, you know, I don't want to cramp his time. He's got his own meetup.
It's his thing.
The what?
He said if he could have asked you, it's his deal.
That's all right. No, I mean, seriously, not everybody wants me to do meetups. I mean, I granted, you know, they're pretty cool and they got Flat Earth Man music, but what, hey, whatever. So also shout outs to the people that sent me real mail, because, you know, my physical address is out there. You can just send me whatever you want. This is a book by Jodel Onstott. I think this was shown to me at the meetup and they actually sent me a copy. It's called Yahweh Exists.
Oh, she was at the conference.
Yes, she was. Light reading. I think this actually has
a big old book.
This has more pages than the actual Bible. So, really, really cool. It's got the Ark of the Covenant on it. I will thumb through what I can here, but I mean, come on. This is not easy reading here.
Not light reading, no.
Speaking of big books, someone was disappointed that during our I've Got Nothing episode that I didn't really have a quote. So I was FedExed 20,000 quips and quotes, a treasury of witty remarks, comic proverbs, wisecracks, and epigrams by Evan Azar. Look at this. So now I will never be without quotes.
Did somebody really send you that so you'll never be without quotes?
Yep. They did.
Oh boy,
that is a lot of quotes. And you can look it up by category. So if there's a topic that you
oh nice
yeah the beginning of this has got an amazing index. So whatever you can, like on forgetfulness, there's got to be like three or four pages just on forgetfulness, or just wives and you know, things that wives do or things that husbands do, and so on and so on. So I am going to slowly but surely punch. I love quotes. I'm gonna punch through some of these.
Well, who sent you that?
Oh yeah, thank you. I have a card.
Hey, thank you. There you go.
I have a card.
That was a thoughtful gift person.
Yes, thoughtful gift person. It was great meeting you at Flattober. You're an awesome speaker. Well, thank you. I do what I can. Seems never a loss of words. Occasionally, seems a shortage of quotes. Here's a gift to help with the next 20,000 shows. Keep up the excellent work. Much love to you and Karen B. Mojo Shop, the guy with the Hawaiian shirt.
With the 20,000 shows, Jesus.
I know. I already found one that, you know, the ones that are really, really good have the author next to them. And one of them was, I once had to spend days during Prohibition living off nothing but food and water. That was said by W.C. Fields.
Hmm.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, there you go. So anyway, thank you for that. Anyone wants to send me anything, you can send it to 2125 Myers Lane. That's in Langley. Trees fall down easily, Washington. 92260. That's not exactly true. I've just never seen anything like that, where I was standing on the deck during the middle of the storm and I could hear on the perimeter. I don't know if you've ever heard this, Karen, where you could hear the cracking. It was, you know, crack, 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 you know,
I have heard that.
Oh, God.
Because I live surrounded by woods. I mean, you've seen where I live.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So when there's a big storm around here, yeah.
Oof. It was not fun. All right.
I got one more shout out.
Who you got?
I'm going to shout out the Truith Mount Meru Summit that Jaron and Austin are putting on.
Oh, right. That's coming up.
It's this weekend, 11/11 and 11/12. And you can use Karen 50 to get your 50% off your ticket price, or you can use a code to support your favorite content provider who is actually speaking at the conference. So there you go. Thames.live. There's your shout out. Woohoo.
Very, very cool. I also, if I'm not mistaken, I got an email. I'm embarrassed to say, though, I may have only glanced at it before it went through my spam folder. There is a Flat Earth Conference in Israel.
What?
Coming up. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Coming up.
Really?
Coming up this weekend, if I'm not mistaken.
Who's running that?
John Pounders? Does that name ring a bell?
He's an American dude.
I know.
But he's doing a conference in Israel.
Yeah,
that's pretty trippy.
Yeah,
right,
that is really, really trippy. But he sent me a thing like last minute. It's like, hey, could you do a shout out? It's like, yeah, yeah. I don't know if I could do.
Does he have a website or anything?
You know what? I will look it up. Or Peanut's gonna look up. Peanut, see if you can find the Flat Earth Conference Israel.
Well, you
thing.
should you know, let me know. I'll link
yeah,
it
I know. From my I, website. Well, I was just he asked me, he's like, oh, hey, can you do like a 2-minute, you know, shout out thing in the conference? He goes, I know it's last minute. It's like, maybe, but I didn't get my power back until,
You know, my I had no idea that was going on. Do you know when it is?
Do I know when or what?
When?
This weekend.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's coming up
in Israel.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Yeah. I'll see if I can. I'll see if I can dig up some more info.
No idea.
I know. That was just it. It's like, look, if you're gonna do something like that, you might want to tell some people that are in the know, that are wired in.
Bob's in chat and he says Brian Pounders.
Are you sure it's not John?
I know the name John Pounders. Now Cammy says.
Yeah, Cammy's saying John Pounders. No, because right. I was interviewed. Yeah, I was. Yeah. Yeah, I was interviewed by John when I went out because he's a good friend of Rick Hummer. And I got a chance to spend some time with him when I was out in Indiana. But that was a couple of years ago.
That's cool.
So. David's speaking Thursday morning at the Jewish conference?
Thursday.
At the Israeli thing?
More specific, David.
Yeah, David. I know. I love it. It's like, I'm speaking Thursday morning. It's like, what?
Okay, so I'm speaking Thursday morning, too, in my bedroom. Like, I don't get it. Where?
what do you say in your bedroom?
None of your business, Mark.
Damn it. Fine. Be that way. Anyway, yeah, David, send us a link. Send Karen a link to this thing. Because literally until I got up this morning, I had no idea it was even happening.
I didn't either. Never even heard of it. Fascinating.
He's doing a whole Peter Jarvio thing. Oh, yeah, by the way, I've been doing campus activism for months on campuses all over the Eastern Seaboard. Really? Yeah. Have you filmed it? No. You're killing me. I am the last speaker, which is 8 a.m. Eastern.
So that means it's before this weekend.
So
on
it starts,
Thursday?
It starts tomorrow on Thursday.
You're so killing confused. Me.
All right.
Anyway.
Well, no, we can talk about this because honestly, when it came to the election, so the show is called Let's Get This Over With, because to my left, and you can't see it, I've got a television monitor with all the channels that are flashing blue and red and blue and red and red and blue and so on and so on. And the quote I gave in the beginning, I'm not kidding. I've never voted for anything ever. I've had no interest in the election process at all because the system, the Americans anyway, checks and balances that we have in there, unless you get a 2-3 majority, you're not going to be able to do much. I mean, oh yeah, you get House and Senate majority, sure. But unless you get a 2-3 majority, you can't really overturn anything. It's just this tug of war, you know. Going back and forth, and I've just always been a believer that, and I feel bad because most of my family members they've always voted their entire life. It's like, oh, you know, we're making a difference, and you really should vote. Yeah, every vote counts. It's like, no, it doesn't. It absolutely does not. They want you to think that, and I don't know if I've told you. It's not a rant. It's just one of my little mantras. I'll give you some perspective here. You probably heard this, Karen. Let's say you're a billionaire, right? You become a billionaire overnight. You win that lottery that just happened. Wonderful distraction, by the way, a $2 billion payout, but whatever. So you win $1 billion, let's say, after taxes. Who do you give your money to? You know, when you're going to, you know, who are you going to endorse? You're going to endorse red team, you're going to endorse blue team. And you weigh your options like, oh, I don't know, you know, I care about the environment, but then there's some health issues over here and I'm pro-business or I'm anti-gun or blah, blah. You just go back and forth and back and forth. It's like, no. You give money to both parties because they don't care. They don't care, you know, about your alliances. They just care about your money. That's it. If you donate $100,000, you will probably be able to take a photo with the president at some dinner. You know, some quick little snapshot that you can put on your mantle. And if you donate $1 million, hell, you might even be able to, you know, play golf with certain members of the administration. You donate several $100 million, then maybe you might be able to influence some policy. The point here is that it took me to be a billionaire or you to be a billionaire to do that. So what's the average Joe lunchbox in the street? What happens to him? What does his vote do?
Nobody cares. They don't care.
They don't care. Absolutely do not care. Money, money rules. That's it. That's the or as the old saying, money talks. That's it. The thing let me end this little part with this. The part that's always bugged me about politicians is their default setting is to overpromise and underdeliver. That's their default setting.
Oh yes.
And then you have most of them that underpromise and never deliver. And then you have some that never intended on delivering ever. You know, the middle group, it's like, oh yeah, I had good intentions. But you have one, it's like, oh yeah, I'm gonna take your money. I have absolutely no intention of giving you anything you wanted. So if that is what a politician is, then what sort of change are you looking for exactly? Again, I'm not criticizing the people that you know, I'm seeing over on the Fox News side of things over there. It's like, oh, the red wave. Even if there is a red wave, what do you think is going to happen? Exactly. What do you think is going to happen tomorrow when we wake up?
It's more the same.
Yeah, when we wake up, there will be elections that are contested. They'll be contested for several days. And then that's really it. And then next week, we don't even hear about it. I also think, by the way, it's hypocritical that today there is no, like Peanut was saying, there's no news. There's no Ukraine. There's no virus thing. There's no Taiwan. There's no Korea. No, it's just the American elections. We just dropped everything. There is, I mean, barely even commercials, just running this red and blue all night. That's all you're going to see.
Well, I'm just hoping the spam texts stop.
Oh, you get some of those?
Oh my God, my phone's been blowing up for like 3 days with all of these BS politic ads.
Yeah.
And I don't even know why they're allowed to do that.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised they got a hold of you. Were you ever on some mailing list?
No. I mean, I don't know. I've had the same phone number since like 2000, you know, so. But I never got spam texts like this year. Super bad. I don't know.
Hmm. I'm scanning some of the news channels. By the way, this is the only show I'm going to do this, where I'm scanning mainstream media, and you know, and blue team is highlighted. They're maximizing. Oh, look at the blue team victories, and red team's like, oh, look at the red team victories. Tomorrow morning, none of it's going to make any difference. So, that's it. Good night, everybody. Oh my God. Seriously, I hate. Days like this because the agenda is to get everyone to care. It's a one day distraction that's been kind of building where people have been chewing on, you know, their local race and the Senate race and the House race.
But, yeah, blah blah blah.
Yeah.
Voting is just a suggestion box for slaves.
It is. I first figured it out just when I was in like my sophomore year of college. And I remember everyone, this was back in the late 80s, right? And I remember everyone during voting day, everyone was lined up like in these staircases. You know, all these kids are lined up patiently to vote. And I remember my roommate was, it's like, oh, dude, have you voted yet? Have you voted yet? And I had no, and granted, I grew up very, very naive on this island of broken trees. And when I had no concept of what it even meant, it's like, why are all you guys lined up for hours to do what exactly? You know, and no one in that staircase couldn't have been maybe 21 tops. And they all seemed to care so much. And it's like, huh. And I didn't, you know, the concept of sheep didn't mean anything to me then. But now I look back, it's like, oh, yeah, that's when they get you. They get you early.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as they can. I mean, there's peer pressure for you. I mean, seriously, I was actually walked towards the line. I was heading towards that line. And I'm looking at just, you know, a couple hundred kids long, you know, spiraling up in the staircase. It was really profound. And I'm looking, I'm going, I got better things to do. I do. I mean, I was, yeah. Granted, I was lazy. I was not a truth. I was not part of the truther community at all. There was no internet. So, but for me, it's like, yeah, you know what? I'm not exactly a follower. Yeah, not going to do it. You guys can, I had no idea what they were even voting for, to be honest.
So you don't even know like who was running or anything? Do you remember? Was it a president?
Oh yeah, I think it was everything. I think it was the presidential election and other fun stuff. But yeah, and then later, because I got in trouble with the government, I was denied my voting rights. So I can't vote now anyway. Or be on jury duty.
Are you a felon?
Karen, how do you not? Of course I am. Where do you think that fireworks story had a happy ending?
I don't remember you telling me that made you a felon.
Oh yeah. Oh. Yeah. Federal. Two counts.
Jeez.
I know, right? I know. I got street cred, right? I could walk into the big house and be like, yeah. For about 10 seconds, and then I get just beat up. Seriously though, when I did the whole fireworks thing, seriously, it was which is why my very first episode of Strange World was called Fireworks, which I talked about. When I got hit, I got hit by the ATF back in the day.
It's
kind of a big deal because I was the kingpin of that operation. Peanut knows the story.
Kingpin, it's so funny.
I know, it was fun.
Mark's gangster.
I know, right? Well, I don't know about that, but it is a kind of a cool story. So if you guys want to know, I won't go into it now because we don't have time. We're going to go to break here one of these days. But if you want, you can listen to the very first Strange World episode, and I had to have a couple of glasses of wine to do it. I broke down over that episode, took the entire episode to do it because it can be a long story of exactly how I got to Colorado. From Seattle and my checkered past, which I don't regret a second of. Not one. But there is here. I'll mention this to you. So there is. So yeah, I can't do jury duty and I can't vote, but I am allowed to have a passport, which is weird. And I even got renewed, right? However, so there was this part. I will mention this before we go to break. So when you fly or if you ever flown, have you ever thought about applying for the whole clear, that clear pass thing? You know what that is? The pre-approved, the pre-security check, the pre TSA.
Oh, okay. Well, I know you can get pre-checks and stuff, but what is that? I don't know.
Well, a pre-check is basically a security clearance. So they basically do a full-blown background check on you. So they don't have to worry, you know, it's like, oh yeah, you're a good guy, you're a good person, so you can skip the line, you can skip the lines. By the way, we had to interview people that you know to vouch for you. You know, it's very much, you know, it's a low level security check, right? Very simple. In fact, I think it's even more invasive than purchasing a firearm type deal. I mean, you have to get interviewed, you know, but people, you know, you have to have references. They come and talk to your references anyway.
Doesn't sound worth it.
I know it doesn't sound worth it. However, I hate lines. You see the story of me and the whole election process thing. So I hate lines. So I thought about doing this. So I went on the online, and you can start the process online, and I'm going through, and they get to this one screen, and I swear, as God is my witness, it's almost like the screen was designed just for me, because they said, "Does anything in your criminal background have anything to do with explosives in any capacity?" And they say, if yes, seriously consider not moving forward with this process and wasting your $60 application fee. Because I mean, literally, they were just saying, just turn around, just close the window.
Don't even bother.
Yeah, don't even bother. if your thing has, my charges literally were manufacturing and distributing explosives without a license. Right. So it was so weird. I mean, I'm looking at the screen. It's like they're telling me to my face, like, go away. Granted, that I was nice that they saved me $60. But
should have been it, but not you, Mark Sargent.
Yeah, right? So I will never be able to go through the TSA process. Now, one of these days, I may just decide to do it for the hell of it anyway. You know, just to get the official letter from them. Because I mean, honestly, I got my passport, and
that's great.
I've traveled to multiple countries and never even stopped, never taken off to a side room. You would have thought was something like that in the background. But who knows? Maybe there's something broken. So if I went through the clear process, then all of a sudden it's like, oh yeah, by the way, your passport, we're going to be revisiting that too. Anyway, there you go. And hey, look at that. We're going to go to break. So when we come back from break, we are going to take your phone calls, 848-222-2480. Just like Karen put in the chat just now, 848-222-2480. There's no odd numbers there. And there's numerology built in. You did it one without the dashes and one with the dashes.
Yeah.
Because some people visually, they can't process.
Well, in case somebody like copies that or whatever.
Oh, right. Right. So yeah, we'll pick up your calls and talk whatever you want. You want to talk about the elections? Hey, great. You could bore me to death with that. I mean, Lord knows Fox News has been doing it for the last 3 hours with me. So Karen, let's play that sweet outro music.
All righty.
All love the Flat Earth Sun, Moon, and Zodiac Clock app, the best tool to show your friends and strangers how the Flat Earth actually works. But are you ready for a Flat Earth app game changer? A new feature has been added. But first, a reminder of some of the existing features. Video of the day. World time. See what time it is all around the Flat Earth. A true Earth compass that shows true navigation across and around the flat Earth plane. Weather. Tap for detailed local weather information. Know what phase and where the moon is at all times. Watch the sun travel between the tropics for the seasons. Select an amazing background. Add a countdown to your next big date. Video playlists in different languages. See the real trade winds circling the flat Earth. Top 21 frequently asked questions with quick pop-up video answers. Access to the best photos and gifts at your fingertips. Flat Earth books and merchandise and more. Now, the game changer upgrade we've always dreamed of having.
Shout out to Karen B, Mark Sargent, David Weiss. I'll be checking out that video this weekend at the Flat Earth, Sun, Moon, and Zodiac Clock app on YouTube. Or
and don't forget to get your tickets for the True Earth Mount Meru Online Virtual Summit. Go to TEMS.live, TEMMS.live. Use Karen50 to get 50% off, or use the code for your favorite content provider and support them at the True Earth Mount Meru Online Virtual Summit. Join me, Karen B., every moon day in the early light, 9:30 a.m. Eastern, on Rockfin, Twitch, and Facebook for an early light chit chat. Open phones, open topics, always chill. I hope to see you there.
Welcome back to Strange World Part 2 of 4. It's you, me, and the always lovely Karen B. And we are taking your phone calls. And you know what? I don't have set up crap.
What?
I don't have Turbo Bridge turned on.
You don't have it open?
Eh, crap. Hang on.
Flipping.
What? Seriously? It's amazing I'm even talking to you right now, but it won't take too long.
Are you running on fumes, Mark?
I am running on so many fumes. It's, you know, again, I didn't think it was that bad when it first started, but there's still people without power, even now, across the island. I've never seen, you know, it's bad when they send in the contractor trucks. A lot of people don't know this. During natural disasters, states will loan out their emergency vehicles, you know, their power equipment guys. Utility trucks will come in from multiple states. Happened to me when I was during the 500 year rainstorm that was out in Colorado, because there's money to be had. Those guys get paid time and a half and double time, and then the companies get paid money. There's just money to be made. And so these guys, all these tree guys, were driving in from everywhere, just this army of trucks looking, you know, because anyone could jump on it. It's like, oh, see that telephone pole? That's ours. That's ours. And they get paid for it, paid well. Okay, well, I've got the call board open. Let's pick up the person that's been on hold the longest. That would be 44 minutes, New Mexico, 505. 505, what's happening, man?
And then coming back from the break, that was Joe Jackson stepping out from his album, Night and Day.
Thank you. Perfect. I didn't have to say it because PETA... I know. And then Karen distracts me and Phoenix's like, yep. Well, at least somebody got it. Crap.
Yep.
Thank you. Thank you, by the way. Thank you. That was Joe Jackson stepping out from his album, Karen.
Night and Day.
Yes, indeed.
All right. Everything's right with the world now.
Yeah, I know.
Wow. Yeah. Just really enjoying you folks tonight, and I it was full moon night, so I got a chance to see it on the horizon rising, which is always a real blessing. And I'm up almost about 7,000 feet, so, and I have a clear shot out east on the rise. And one of the things that I always notice, and I just wanted to put it out there and see any comments, is, you know, when you get it on that rise so high up, and I don't know if it's just the elevation, but usually the first 5 minutes, it's so spectacular, but it always seems like it's just a little bit smushed down. Looks like a squished ball a little bit. And I don't know if that's what everybody else is getting. And there's never really a complete roundness to it. And then after about 10 minutes, that's when things start kind of looking more like the normal moon that we usually see. But I was just always wondering about that, if you folks ever saw it. What? Any comments?
I don't. Do you care? Sorry, no, I don't. I don't have an opinion on this at all.
I guess I don't really either.
Yes.
Sorry.
It's just pretty cool. It just never ceases to amaze me when I see that full moon rise. I don't know if it's an elevation thing.
You mean like how the moon looks more squished through the atmosphere? Is that what you're talking about?
Maybe.
Or like it's orange. It'll be like orange or something. It's just because it's lower. You're looking more horizontal through lower level atmosphere, I would think, is what it is.
Yeah, I'm a big believer in atmospheric lensing on all levels. And I'm a little surprised that even though atmospheric lensing is a meteorological term, why scientists still aren't, you know, running to this in all things. They go, you know, because there's lots of publications say, the moon's smaller in the sky. It's a mystery. We don't know why. It's like, what are you talking about? You mentioned atmospheric lensing for everything else. Why not the moon? Why the hell not? It's an object in the distance through the atmosphere. Sure.
True. Yeah, because those first few minutes, it looks like a completely different thing than what we see the rest of the night or throughout the rest of the ride.
Yeah, it's higher in elevation, there's less atmospheric distortion.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you ever get, I don't know how close you are to the water, Karen. Do you ever get it on the, I've never actually caught it on, you know, rising from the water, but I would imagine that would be just as spectacular because you just got a clear view of their flat horizon.
I've got sunrise over the water, but I haven't done moonrise over the water yet. I would like to, though. That would be cool. That would be cool.
Yeah. And on the full moon, too, I was wondering, Karen, I don't know if this is something you ever looked into, but any more Bigfoot activity or less on full moon? You know, we've always heard this over the years about how it affects, you know, everybody. Anything with Bigfoot?
I can't say that I've noticed any more or less around full moon or new moon, or I don't even know what phase of the moon it is whenever something happens, because that's like the last thing I'm thinking about. But
yeah,
I don't, not that I've noticed.
I mean, it
yeah,
I've noticed that it aggravates Ted's werewolf traits, but in a sexy way.
Oh boy. Ouch.
What? Was that, is this group chat? What is this? Anyway, what else you got? Sorry, I had to throw that in there. I know Ted's listening tonight, so.
Yeah. No, that's pretty much it. Just wanted to share that with you folks and just really enjoying you guys tonight as usual. And let's see, I'll do a couple shout outs, of course, to Mark and Karen. And shout out to William in California and, of course, Jan in Dallas. And everybody keep it flat and enjoy your flat election night.
Thank you, man.
All right, thanks.
Appreciate it.
Okay. See you, buddy.
By the way, before I pick up the next caller, and I'll probably pick up Canadian next because, well, they have a talk up, you know, they're between Middle Earth and Narnia.
Right.
So weirdness abounds up there. Peanut mentions that Artemis, the moon project, has been now bumped to November 16th. Any bets on if it's going to go off in 8 days? I don't think it's going to. I think they'll kick it down the road again and kick it down till Christmas. And then maybe in January, just blow it up on the pad.
Is that supposed to be the Orion thing or the...
No, that's the moon. That's the beginning of the new moon missions. The Artemis, right.
Artemis, that's right.
Artemis, the first moon going around the moon without people in it, because that's what you do. And then,
oh, that's right, they're going to test it first because we've never been there.
We did test it like it's brand new.
Right.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Never done this before, unprecedented.
Yes. All right, let's pick up let's pick up Canada and then we'll probably do Texas. 905, what is happening up in the land of hockey pucks and cheese?
Things are great up here. Well, at least for me personally, not for politically.
Why are things good for you personally, just cuz?
I met somebody who's totally cool and on game, so it's pretty damn awesome.
Right on.
But the previous caller, he totally stole my Joe Jackson call out because I was going to do it too.
Damn.
Well, he was still on hold before the music even rang. I was like, he's not going to say it.
What are people taking bets now? Mark's going to get distracted. He's not going to say it. Tonight.
Yeah, well, it's a highlight of every episode.
Thank you.
But, so if I can harp on the Ukraine thing.
Sure. That's a thing right now? Go ahead.
Well, though, the thing is that it's not. And my confusion is, are people just like dumb and ignorant? Or are they purposely putting the Ukraine flags upside down on their cars, in their windows and stuff?
No, they're ignorant.
Because I see so many.
No, that's a good point, because a lot of flags, you don't, there's no distinguishing feature that puts it top from bottom. You know, like the American flag, obviously we have that corner, you know, but other flags, you don't know, you know, if it's just horizontal stripes, like a lot of flags, like the Russian flag would be the same thing. What's on top? Peanut probably knows.
Want to say blue.
Is it blue, white, red? Is that what it is? Is
red, white, flag blue.
Blue, white, red? No? Blue, red, white? Somebody help me out. Anyway, so you know what? I don't even know. What's the Ukraine top color? Blue or yellow?
Oh, it's blue over yellow.
It is blue over yellow, but you're seeing a lot of yellow over blue?
It'd be like the sky over the wheat is what the lovely lady told me, which makes perfect sense, and that's the way it's supposed to be. But
do all flags peanut has a point, which understand. Is do in with every flag, if you turn every flag upside down, is that the distress signal, or is it just the United States?
Or are they just secretly pro Russia?
Oh, that's a good point too. I don't know.
It's I see it constantly upside down, and I think it's mostly ignorance, but
probably
at the same time, if they don't want to hang a Russia flag off their front porch, just hang the Ukraine one upside down. And yeah,
well, you know, well, the ignorance would continue, because if you hung a Russian flag off your deck, there's a lot of people wouldn't even know what it was. People would be like, is that France? Yes, it is France. No.
Red, white, and blue. USA.
Yeah, exactly. Is that the new American flag? No. No, it's not. But don't forget what I said a couple shows ago, which is you could take Ukraine at this point and just burn it down. You could take the capital city and just turn it into rubble. And the average American would be like, so where's Ukraine again? It's like, okay, it's a hint. It's next to Russia and the Black Sea. And that really should be all the hints you need. That people would just, yeah, they wouldn't get it. So no, ignorance rules the day. And now, honestly, I mean, what, I can't wait. So after the whole election thing is done, are we just going to go back to Ukraine? Is that going to be the new thing? I don't know. It's silly.
Kick the can down the road again, Mark.
Well, that and Artemis. Yeah. Anyway, what else you got? Anything?
No. Just love you, Karen, Peanuts, everyone in the chat, and thanks for taking my call. And have a great night, guys.
All right.
And I love
right, you guys too.
You, Ginger. I was gonna be a smartass. I love. I know. You, Ted. I mean, Ginger. Damn it. All right.
Have a great night, guys.
See you, man. All right, let's go to Texas, wonderful state of Texas. 214 to me and Karen B. What's happening?
Hello, to Mark, Karen, and Peanut. Glad Peanut is doing so much better. It was nice to hear from Ginger.
Yeah, we haven't heard from him in a while.
Mm-hmm. And I was wondering, Mark, with these felonies of yours, when you date someone seriously, do you mention that to those women?
Oh,
it's his pickup line.
Yeah, actually, depending on what bar it is, that is my go-to line. 'Cause I don't look the part, so it helps me butch up. I just kind of lean in. It's like, hey. You know, in some places I can't cross state lines. No. I do tell people, but generally, I mean, again, Jen, you've heard the story, haven't you? You've listened to Strange World 1.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's fantastic.
Well, thank you. I mean, well, that's just it. It's such an interesting story, and I'm not trying to toot my own horn. It really is a good story. that that by the time I get done, people just kind of gloss over the fact that it's like, oh yeah, by the way, federal felon. It's like, oh really? So no, I do tell everyone that I can. Most of the time, when
weather
permitting.
Right in there with you.
The what?
Your family was right in there with you, supporting you, and I don't want to spoil the story for anybody, but that big red thing was fabulous.
Well, yes.
True.
Yeah, the otherwise known as the Alpha Omega, the biggest firecracker, one of the biggest firecrackers ever built. Yeah, I was glad the ATF never got a hold of
it. It was almost like a script. It was almost like you wrote a script. It was so perfectly done, and it really was like a script.
Well, thank you. Thank you. I did turn it into a screenplay, believe it or not, for a friend who was in film school down in California.
Oh, you did?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And it was entered into years ago, 20 years ago, into the original Project Greenlight. It was done by Ben Affleck and Matt Damon. So, yeah.
Well, cool.
Really?
Yeah. It was a fun, again, it's an embarrassing time in my life, but yet I if I had to do it over again, I'd probably do it. So, but to your point, yes, I do tell people whenever I can. I try to be as transparent as possible, which is why I put my physical address and everything else out there on the internet.
You have to do it over again, Mark. You need to learn not to mix business with pleasure. That's what got you messed up.
You remember that part?
I know the chick snitched you out.
Yeah, that New York girl who let's just call her Lori because her name is actually Lori. Lori Austin, to be more specific. She never got a hold of me afterwards. But yeah, girl from New York. Never. I have this piece of wisdom to the men out there. Men will talk a lot of smack. Right. And but they won't mean it. You know, they'll talk a lot. They'll make plans and they'll make threats, but they're idle threats. When a woman comes to you and you know, with a dead serious voice and says, if you mess with me, I'm going to drop the dime on you. And actually says the term drop the dime. Yeah. Take them very seriously. Women, I will never underestimate a woman after that. Ever, ever. But yes, to Karen's point. Don't mix business with it, of course, it's easy to say that now, but when you're 21, right? Yeah. when you're not even 21, I was 20, and you know, and most of the employees that I had working for me were women, because they were just better at it than men were. They were way more focused, and they just seemed more attention to detail. They're more driven, and you know, I could give them it's like, oh, here's half a mile of fuse and some scissors, cut them up into 4-inch pieces, bring them back to me when you're done. I could trust them. They'd be like, and they'd come back. It's like, oh yeah, here, pay me. It's like, okay. And that's what the whole thing came down to. Money. 9 out of 10 problems in the world. Money. The girl wanted the money. My current girlfriend did not want her anywhere near me. And the girl said, you pay me for what I was going to make for the summer. We're only talking in hindsight. Here's hindsight for you. Ready, Karen? In hindsight, I probably should have given her $1,000 for doing nothing. That would have saved me, bought me some
probably
time. Don't know what that would have changed in the long run. Probably still would have gotten caught, but that's all it was. She burned me for $1,000. Now granted, it was $1,000 in 1989, which was a little bit of money, but all right. Anyway, thank you for letting me reminisce, Jen.
The man you are today. Yeah.
There you go. Without that, I wouldn't even be in the same room with Karen. I wouldn't.
Well, that's the truth. Yeah.
So.
And I hope people who haven't heard it will go back to hear that two-parter. And I would just like to make a comment, and you can tell me to stop if you don't want me to say any more.
Stop.
But
what?
I believe that God is going to help America out greatly and help us fix the 2020 election. I'm waiting for that. I believe that he will help us fix that. And I'd like to, and Danielle, I know, from Quebec is on that board too. And I'd like to say shout out to John and William and the lovely lady in British Columbia and everybody in Canada. And Ginger, it was so good to hear from him, and hope all the Flat Earther people are doing well tonight, and have a good tomorrow.
Well, thank you, Jen. Keep hope alive. You are not alone there.
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
All right. You have a good evening, Jen, and we will talk soon.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Now she made me all nostalgic about my early years. Although, I wouldn't have changed much because the timeline was so fragile. You know, people's like, oh, I would have changed this. And I would, you know, think about it hard before you get a time travel machine and start changing stuff.
Yeah.
It is the butterfly effect all over the place. And if you haven't seen The Butterfly Effect with Lord Deliver Us from Ashton Kutcher, it's still a good movie. It absolutely wonderful, but especially the director's cut. The director's cut is dark, freaking dark. Let's go to, oh crap, where did I leave off? Did I pick up Phoenix? Peanut? I haven't picked up Phoenix, no.
I think so.
Let's go out to 602. What's happening?
Line unmuted. Hey, guys. I love that. How you guys doing?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing great. Mark, you know, I look at you, you're such a tall, sexy, handsome man. I can't believe you're not with another tall, handsome, sexy man. I can't understand.
You mean other than Ted, who we're not supposed to talk about on air? Ted, call me.
You're gorgeous, so there's nothing to say there. That's it. I just you know, bow down, and that's the end of that. Mark, on the other hand, to work with you a little bit here.
My cute days are long in the rear view mirror, my friend. Seriously. Thank you, though.
I'm older, so I know exactly what you're talking about. I was born in 66, brother.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Yeah.
Damn right, I know what you're talking
about. I look in the mirror, and I don't see it.
I don't stand together. Yeah. I'm sorry, what'd you say?
I was saying, when I look in the mirror, I don't see it. When photographers look at me, oh, yeah, they see it. they don't see it. They look at me, and it's like, yeah, you know those people that are photogenic? Yeah, that's not this guy. He's not.
Yeah. Oh, what amazes me is how women, as they mature, they get more beautiful. And I look at myself in the mirror and I go, how is it possible that a gorgeous, more, you know, older, beautiful woman could want, you know, like looking at yourself as, for instance, in the mirror? And you're you shake your head.
Trust me, man. I mean, I live under a bridge and grab passing travelers from time to time and say things like, I'll grind your bones to make my bread. The bells, Esmeralda.
I love you guys. Oh, I do. I just been going through my own craziness over here in my life, but you know. I just try and listen in all the time, and you know, you were talking about the elections earlier. I was like, oh my god, I if somebody brings this up again, I want to strangle them. Like, no more, this is insanity. I mean, everybody's voting for their own slavery. It's like, really, when are you gonna stop?
Yep.
When are you gonna stop voting for your own damn slavery? That's what I want to know. When are people gonna freaking stop voting for their goddamn slavery, Mark? Karen, can you give me an answer?
I'm going to say mostly never, because outside of the audience that is listening to this show right now and some select others, most of the world, I believe, are just background fillers. They're just NPCs, just walking around like zombies, doing what they were told to do.
Mark, Karen, I've been thinking about this whole apocalypse thing, and I think the apocalypse thing is very real, but it's only meant for the chosen few who can freaking see what the hell's going on.
You're not wrong.
Think about it.
Yeah?
Think about it. Think about what I just said. We are all awake. What about the rest of the bleeping freaking morons in the world who are completely asleep at the wheel?
Well,
what is going to happen? What is going to happen when they pull the EBT cards, guys, what's going to happen when the money stops flowing? We're real close. Months away, maybe? Weeks? I don't know.
We'll see.
What's going to happen?
Hey, my you know? Conscience is clear. It is. I've made as much content as I had. I've sent it out to my family members and friends and former coworkers and done everything I can. So there's no way I'm going to feel guilty at all when whatever happens, happens. I mean, seriously, I will not feel a shred of guilt because they had planned. Hell, my channel was almost burned down several times because it was trying to speak my mind. So don't worry about it. Just, hey, you know, if you're awake, that's all that matters. How's that?
You know what kills me? I don't worry about it, but what really kills me, what breaks my heart, is having to watch this. Is having to watch it, and I know the tough lessons to learn. Get granted, we got all this, right? We all got this in the memos. Tough lessons to learn. Wake up, you're gonna get slapped in the face. Yep. But it's still very hard to watch. Very hard to watch. But I mean, how hard is it got to be to watch a family member taking the poison, right, in their arm over and over and over? Someone you know in 30, 40 years, right?
It's true.
And they inject themselves with the poison because they are completely and totally, you know, brainwashed by the system.
I agree. Hey, it's hate to do sad. This. Hey, stop it for a second. We're out of time. We gotta go to break.
Sorry.
That's all right. It's not your fault. I wasn't watching either. And then Peanut's like banging his head. It's like, go to break. Go to break. His headset. He's throwing it off. He's lighting up like three cigarettes at a time. Anyway, when we come back from break, we will take your phone calls. But thank you. I seriously appreciate your enthusiasm and, of course, your candor. So, Karen, what is our outro music for the second time? So I was told, no, that's wrong. I was instructed by Karen B to do a commercial for Truth Smacks. So this is it. So yeah, Truth Smacks, Trail Mix Supreme. This is the freedom version. Spreading truth one delicious morsel at a time. Yeah, there's a QR code on the back. You probably can't see it very well here, so maybe Karen will put it up on the screen here. Maybe put a nice ding sound to it, like here, ding, or here, we're here, but not in front of my face. It's in front of my face, isn't it? The QR code, it's blocking my face. All right, fine. While it's blocking my face, I'll read the ingredients. There's walnuts, pumpkin seeds, dark chocolate, cashews, pecans, coconut sugar, Himalayan salt, raisins, dates, peppermint, and one thing that was left out, which is truth. So yeah, Truth Smacks. And see what I did there? It's in front of my face now, so you can't even see the product. So nice going, editor, whoever's editing this. Wait, you're showing the bag, aren't you? Ha! See? No, now it's the QR code again. Well, let's try it again. Yeah? No? This is what happens when you don't do all of your own work. You record something and you hope it's going to turn out well, and you hand it over to the editors and they completely botch it up. So yeah, that's it. Truth Smacks. One morsel at a time. Something, something. Buy it. Support Flat Earth people. Welcome back to Strange World, part 3 of 4. It's you, me, and the always wonderful Karen B. And hey, Karen, you could answer this question. I was looking over chat room. The important question is, what is the name of this song?
That is Chief Crow and the Flat Earth Worms.
I'm in a cult.
Is it I'm in a cult? Is that the name of it?
Isn't it?
I guess it is. I'm not sure, to be honest with you. I have to look.
It's got to be, right? Isn't it? Crap.
Ball Earth Cult. That's what it's called.
Ball Earth Cult.
Ball Earth Cult.
Yeah. Yeah. And I had a chance to see him live at Karen's conference.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very cool. Cool guy.
He's a great guy.
Yeah.
Very talented.
Not as weird as I thought he would be.
Well, maybe you didn't talk to him for very long.
Oh, really? Is he that way?
No, I'm just kidding. He's a really nice guy.
Does he talk like that most of the time?
No, he just does it sometimes to mess around, but it's funny. He's a cool guy.
Cross between Sling Blade and someone who's got a voice box. Rawr, rawr, rawr. Yeah, Ball Earth Cult is the name. Yeah, very, very cool. What's Peanut writing me? Watching these numbers seems always to... Yeah. All right, so let's grab the phone calls. By the way, phone number to call in is 848-222-2480. That's 848-222-2480. Let's try Georgia. Why the hell not, right? 706, you're on. Don't be nervous.
Well, now you done made me nervous. Come on now.
What? Is this your first time calling in? Georgia.
Yeah.
Cool. So what's up?
Yeah, this one, call in, represent Georgia. Shout out to Marshall Sound and Video. Got to go to a little meetup he had about 2 years ago. Call in and tell y'all how much we love you.
Thanks. Yeah, Nathan. That's my homie.
Oh, yeah. He was awesome. It was a fairly small crowd, but it was quite enjoyable.
Nice. That's great. Anything else?
No, nothing major. Just go call in and tell y'all how much we appreciate you.
All right. Y'all
have a great one.
Thank you.
I will put you back on mute because I very rarely kick people off. You will not be that person today, but thank you.
Why not? It's fun.
Well, oh, you want me? Is that what you want? You want me to kick you off? Nope, I just put him on mute. I couldn't do it. In fact, I don't even know what happens when you kick somebody off. You know, you have been disconnected or something like that. We should test that out to see what happens.
See what it says.
Yeah. Why not? Okay, so that was Georgia. You know what? Let's see what Dennis is doing. Because I've got a great shot of him and Chief Crow and is it Frankie? Is that his name? The Asian kid with the camera. Is that his name?
Shoot. I think so.
The guy who was passing out Jack's lotion. Which sounds so weird. Which we sounds didn't awful. We didn't talk about on air last week. We're probably not going to talk about it now. but we're going to pick up Dennis. 504. Dennis, are you driving a truck somewhere in the Northwest?
Yes, sir, in Salem, Oregon.
Salem, Oregon. How's it going?
Pretty good. Actually, just this past week, I was texting back and forth with Chief Crow. I don't know if he'll make a meetup of it or not, but he might meet up. He may be coming to Oregon in December, so I may meet up with him then. He told me at the conference, you remember that conference that I did in Salem, Oregon back in 2017.
Yes.
He said that was the first Flat Earth meetup he had ever been to.
I did not know that.
Yeah. Chief Crow. He's from Oregon, or he's living in Idaho now, but at any rate, yeah, he's when we go back, I've known him about as long as I've known you. right up, well, within the same year, at any rate. Hey, I just wanted to say, well, two things if I've got the time. But first, as far as Flattoberfest, I know it's not Flatter Conference 2023. I take it, would that be on the weekend of tentatively, is it Saturday the 21st and Sunday, is it the 21st and 22nd of October 2023, would it be?
Possibly.
Dennis, why you try to nail?
I can't say for sure because I don't have anything like set. I'm still shopping for venues, so I can't tell you for sure. But that is the weekend. I'm trying to go for the same weekend. Okay, the third weekend in October. So
I remember. I was gonna say about the moon, but if I say it real quick, I'll say it another time. I remember on nostalgia. We were on Facebook one time, and it was I'll just repeat it because it's, it's good stuff. When Karen gave that kind of response to a question I had, I said, this was, 2 years ago, was it? I asked, is Rob Skiba going to come to the Flattoberfest? And I was expecting Rob Skiba to answer because he was active in that conversation. And Karen chimed in, is like, I don't know who the speakers are yet. And I was like, no, that's not what I'm asking. I was like, I mean, that's all great if he's a speaker, but I just wanted him to, I just want to know if he'd hang out with a guy and buy a beer with him. And Rob Skiba actually gave a thumbs up to that. So that was actually the last form of any kind of communication that I had with him. But when you said that about the, you hadn't got the date yet, that it brought that to mind. But anyway, I'll just say about for Flattoberfest, it's near the Grand Canyon, and probably my wife and I will take off the whole week prior to and visit the Grand Canyon. And I would just, that's a suggestion. That's something for people that are going to go there because it's very close and doable from Las Vegas.
Well, you know what, Dennis? Dennis, did you know there's a total eclipse the 14th, which is the weekend before that weekend, and it happens to run through the north side of Nevada. Like, it goes from Oregon to Nevada. It's like, goes across down that way. So if you wanted to, you could even make a trip where you went to go see the total eclipse, and then you went to Flattoberfest.
That'd be great for me personally. I'm in Oregon, and I think I checked it out after you said it. It's going to pass through southern Oregon, mm-hmm. and so I'm not too far from it. But I'd like to visit. I mean, just my personal. There's a system of 30 Greek monasteries in the U.S., and the chief one is in the desert in Arizona, about, 45 minutes southeast of Arizona. So in the early part of the week when people, I don't like the crowds, and I'll go to the monastery, and later part of the week when people are going home, then I may check out the Grand Canyon and then Flattoberfest on the weekend. That's just my personal itinerary.
Sounds
good. That's all I got.
All right.
Well, thank you, Dennis, for letting us know you're nailing down your plans a year from now.
Planning ahead.
Yeah.
Everything I do, it's 90% preparation and 5 or 10% execution.
I hear you, man. I'm all over it. All right, man. Any shout outs before I let you go?
Chief Crow and there's a couple people, I can't remember them. So, Mark Sargent, everybody. Thank you. And great Flattoberfest again, by the way.
Right on, Dennis.
Thanks, Dennis.
All right. See you, man. Bye-bye. See you. You know, Dennis has a good time. You can tell when somebody has a good time when they're immediately saying, when's the next one? I know it's a year out, but we need to nail down dates.
I had people emailing me. They're all, what are your plans? What's the next one? And I was like, geez. But hey, you know what? That a happy customer is a repeat customer, I guess.
That is true. That is what my dealer says.
I'm just glad that it makes everybody so happy because it stresses me the hell out. And so I'm always just like, man, this better be worth it. And then in the end, it usually is worth it. So
that is true. Out of all the people who were there, you were the only one that was, other than some of the audiovisual people, were kind of, you know, kind of focused.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
It was nice that you found some time to cut loose every once in a while.
Yeah, it was cool. It was cool.
And show up at my hotel room door early with Ted.
That's right.
Yep.
It was fun. The shenanigans were fun. It's going to be even more fun next year.
Oh, well, good. Yeah. I'm sure there could put possibly people adding to their arrest records.
No, come on.
Come on. You can't say that's outside of the realm of possibility.
Nobody, no. I mean, it's not, but that never, stuff like that never happens.
So far, you were right. We have never had an event where, I don't think we've had an event where we needed to post bail for something.
In such a good mood and so happy, there's not usually anything bad happening.
Yeah.
Outside of like maybe some projectile vomiting from too much imbibing.
Yeah, that doesn't count. So gross. Okay, let's go to... Let's grab. Oh, I don't think I picked up Alabama yet. Alabama, have I picked you up yet?
Hello?
Alabama, are you there?
Yes, sir. Mr. Mark and Miss Karen B, how y'all doing?
Good. How are you?
Oh, you're doing good.
Yeah,
good. This is the Mojo Shop, and I see you got my book.
Oh, you're the guy that sent me the 20,000 quips and quotes in this giant book. Very, very cool. No, seriously, great gift. Thank you. I am going to cherish this.
You were supposed to get it at Flattoberfest, although there was a mix-up and it got mislaid with a whole bunch of other stuff I had done up there, but that's okay. We got one to you.
Nice. Well, thank you. Seriously, I appreciate it a great deal.
Yeah, before you go, see what's any categories for the Globe or, you know, the rocket space.
Oh, there's, yeah, I am sure I am going to be using this for show quotes. No question.
All right, man. Hey, y'all have a good night, and shout out to everybody in the community. Y'all have a great evening. Bless y'all.
All right. See you, man.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. What happened? There was somebody from New York that was calling in. His name is, well, let's just call him Alex. And now he's not there anymore. He disappeared. Which means, since Alex hung up, the phone lines are officially open right now. Believe it or not. There's somebody else that's just listening, and we already picked up these people and picked up everybody. So if anybody wants heavy launch happened, right? No. So I'm reading the chat room. You mean, no, the Artemis? No, the Artemis has been pushed off to the 16th. No, we would have heard about it. That would have been like my topic of the evening if the Artemis would have actually lifted off. It has not. So no despair bear. That's what you're talking about? No.
They have been shooting rockets up in the air, though. I mean, like they're supposedly launched some like supply mission thingy. I don't know. And then there was also that video that recently came out on YouTube. I don't know if you saw it, called where Dude Perfect goes to space in that.
Oh, that piece of crap.
Yeah. Wasn't that ridiculous?
The fact that he went out of his way to mention the curvature of the Earth, even though the camera was doing the whole bending horizon thing. Yeah. Yeah. Just silly. Absolute silly. Anyway, here's a phone call that came in. 207. Let's pick them up. By the way, the phone number is 848-222-2480. That's 848-222-2480. What's ME? Is that Maine?
Yes.
207, are you in Maine?
Yes, I am. Portland, Maine.
Wow. Land of Stephen King. We don't get a lot of calls from Maine. What's happening up there?
Oh, not much. Just calling the OGs of Flat Earth.
You calling Karen old? Better be careful.
I am old. It's okay.
Which like powers?
No, so listen to this. So I'm watching Netflix today, and there's this movie called The Girl in the Shed, and it's about this like guy who kidnaps this girl in New Hampshire. It's like one of those Lifetime movies, you know. And so of course they portray this guy to be a flat earther. He's got like the NASA, you know, with the emblem on it with the lies on it.
Yeah.
And he's like a conspiracy theorist, you know, talking about 9/11. And of course he's a kidnapper rapist. So it's like, it's hilarious how they're trying to portray this dude as like, you know, a bad guy, a flat earther.
Sure.
And it's like, it's so blatantly obvious when, you know, it's messed up, but it's like, and I'm looking up the movie and it's a true story. And this guy was like, this is 2013 and this took place. And it's like, there's no way, like the finance wasn't even like a movement back then. You know what I mean? So
it's, no, it wasn't. Yeah.
Lies on there. Yeah. So it's just like,
interesting.
I mean, just like,
I'm going to look this one up. Girl in the Shed.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, check that movie out. It's called A Girl in the Shed. And just, you know, if you want a good laugh, but anyway, yeah, I've been watching you guys since like 2016. You know, it's awesome. Keep up the good work.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Cool. Is that it?
All right. Just wanted to, yeah, I just want to throw that out there.
Right on, man. Well, hey, you have a good night. Okay.
All right. You do.
Yeah. Bye. We do not get a lot of calls from Maine.
No, we do not.
So, but I'm sure there's blue dots up there. DITRH, I'm sure can confirm. There's a bunch of blue dots up there. There's blue dots everywhere.
There's blue dots.
So, well, I'm just going to pick up whoever calls next. So, phone number. This is your chance on election night.
Oh my God!
What? So exciting, election night. 848-22. No, I turned it off over there. I couldn't watch anymore. It was just people pointing at graphs and map and state maps with counties on them. That's all they were doing nonstop. Yes, doing what Peanut's doing right there. The way Peanut's just motioning. Here's a call that's, wait, no, oh no, now we got calls. Sorry.
There are lots of blue dots in Maine, by the way.
Yeah, let's pick up good. Let's pick up 646 out of New York. What's happening, 646?
Vote for Pedro, buddy. Do it.
Who's Pedro?
Come on, man.
Seriously, I do not follow politics at all. Who's Pedro?
Slow news night, man.
It's from Napoleon Dynamite, man.
Vote for Pedro is from
for
that
Pedro,
movie.
Napoleon Dynamite. Wow, that doesn't date you at all. There are kids out there going, "Who the hell is Napoleon Dynamite?"
That's like right up your alley.
Really? Because you see me as him? Duh.
No, it's just because you're really good with media, and like Napoleon Dynamite's like right there in the middle. It's like right there.
Yeah, no, I mean that was one of those.
Everyone knows who Pedro is.
Good point. Pedro. Vote for Pedro. Wow.
Yeah, but anyway, red wave, baby. Whatever that means.
That doesn't mean good things as far as I'm concerned.
No, I don't have any idea what it means. I really don't. It just feels like the same old thing.
It is.
That we always go through.
It's just the same old BS we've been watching for years, you know, for decades now. I've seen so many elections, and nothing has ever amounted to squat. The world is no better than it was. In fact, it's worse.
Yep.
Governments only make things worse. Politicians are all liars. Everybody is 100% corrupt. I care nothing about elections. Nothing.
Just
less
keep
than
going,
nothing.
Karen, just keep going. Say more of that and just cuss more and. You know, do that.
No, I mean, that's seriously, that's why the show is called Let's Just Get This Over With, because I this time next week I hope that it's just purged from my brain where I don't have everything that's going to be contested tomorrow is resolved and we can just move on to the normal BS. Because tonight is extra special sauce BS. This is the where they just that the news basically tells you what to think for an entire evening. It's like you must focus on this. This is the only thing we're going to talk about. So you got to drill down.
And they just try to make you feel like hey, this is important tonight.
It is.
Tonight it's important.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Can you feel it? And then if you're like, we've got to master some way to create the ultimate meme that describes the kicking the can down the road, because it doesn't apply just to politics. It applies to Flat Earth, NASA, it applies to all of the bullshit. The kicking the can down the road is the ultimate skipping down past people's memory levels until they're like, shit, they forgot that we lied to them yesterday. We're just going to do it again tomorrow.
It's true.
Somebody's got to get their arms around that and do the ultimate meme. That's my challenge. To Flat Earth World.
When Irving came up for Flat Earth and then Shaquille O'Neal followed him and Shaquille O'Neal had to backtrack 10 days later because his sponsors were all over him. Fast forward 3 years later to 2022 and he gets back into it during an Australian radio show and some media are treating it like it's a brand new thing. Like it never happened in the past. And I'm thinking, what, some intern who was 23 now was still in high school, when Shaq first came out. It's like, oh, Shaquille's into Flat Earth. Oh, my God.
You got to remember, a lot of the people, in our scene have long memories.
Yes.
And a lot of the people that we're battling are either NPCs or souls in the making and very short memories. And so they have memories 5 minutes behind, 5 minutes into the future. But we're the ones that remember everything way back. So we're in a battle really with time and memory with a lot of these people, right? Does that make any sense? We're just remember we talked about this 3 years ago, we talked about this 5 years ago. Mm-hmm. But people are like, I don't remember talking about this at all. I don't remember any of this shit.
Yeah.
Because they throw so much at people. Before you can even process one thing, they're throwing another thing at you.
Yep.
And that's part of their that's their that is the way.
Yeah. I know. It drives me insane and all.
I'm going to leave.
Okay, man.
Hey. Love you guys. Bye.
All right, see you, man.
Later.
I kind of like with the whole, we got to get a break. The whole thing with Elon, which is, by the way, he's the richest man in the world and he's telling everybody to vote Republican and he's firing everybody at Twitter. And it's like,
and he's charging everybody $8 a month to be verified on Twitter. $8 a month. Verified on Twitter, otherwise you are considered a bot. You are relegated to the bottom of the feed with bots.
He's gonna auger that thing into the ground. I'm hoping that, well, I'm not hoping anything. I hope honestly he gets hit by his own bullet train, but it's all right, he'll get his in the end. All right, with that, we are going to go to our final break, and then we'll take your phone calls. I will, when we come back, I'm going to try to pick up 657-602 and anybody else afterwards. So, Karen, the final outro music before Alex's final outro music. Third break, whatever. Where is the curvature?
On property approaching food trailer.
Engage Delta 9.
Roger. Alpha 33 descending.
Hey, I know you.
They might be listening.
CIA?
Maybe.
Aliens?
Probably.
Globalists?
Definitely. I may have already said too much.
We have what you need.
Really?
It's flat.
I'm listening.
And round.
Go on.
And delicious.
Tell me the secret.
Hey,
truth in it.
I thought you might.
This truly is a special place.
Yeah, we like to think so.
Will you be here tomorrow?
We move around quite a bit.
Ah, a mobile command center. A strong strategy. I like where your head's at.
Anything else?
I was never here.
Long live Flat Earth.
Long live Flat Earth.
You just missed.
Welcome back to Strange World Part 4. It's you, me, and the always wonderful Karen B. And sometimes Ted. yeah. So we're taking some phone calls, and the callers that called before we left for the break are still there. Let's surprise them, shall we? 657, unmuted. Hey, you gotta I'm talk here. Now.
Hello.
Hey, what's up? What's going on?
Hey, same thing every day. No, I just was going to call, listen to you for a long time, for a while. You were the one that I guess started me with the questions. And I always used to say that sometimes it's better to ask the question than it is to get the answer. And it just led me down the road there for a little bit. And I was going to tell Miss Karen. I was listening to her deal about the petrified wood the other day. And one thing that it does turn into is moon rocks.
Yeah. It's funny.
Yeah. So it was, you know, that was a pretty good little deal. I don't know where they come from. So, you know, it all has to make sense. I'm going to lean a little bit toward... we're not the first person to rent the apartment. And maybe it started over. Remember Etch-A-Sketch?
Sure.
You get done with it, you shake it, turn it over, you start again. Still got little marks in there from the last drawing or whatever.
Right.
So, you know, I don't know whether we've got Etch-A-Sketched or whatever, but I said I just started asking answering questions whenever you started with the clues back years ago. But it was been a pretty good little travel.
Awesome. So you've never called into the show?
No.
Huh?
No, I'm out here in California. Moved from Texas. Should be going back the other way, but I'm not right now anyway. But it was I guess that, you know, you with the conspiracies, not theories, because a theory is just somebody's idea, but the conspiracy can be proven easy if you got two or more people trying to screw shit up. But that's all you got to prove. And I'm old enough to remember Vietnam. and everybody's ideas back and forth. So we're getting back into that same little dance with Ukraine and all this other stuff that we did back in those days. And if actually, if you're old enough to remember, you would go to church and they would preach, you know, kill him, you know, whatever. And it was all the way through, you know, the society all the way down. So now, you know, just comes new stuff and have been, I'm going to say, on the conspiracy side for a long time, too. I sort of lean toward somebody was asking, I think it was somebody the other day, about the reincarnation and how they, you know, explain the reincarnation. I think it was Jaron. But anyway, it was, you know, if kids die, you know, it would be better to kill the children right away, is to let them grow up into this world or whatever. Now, you know, that's not quite the idea, but we're not serious about curing the problems at all. If they wanted to cure the problem of abortion, it's easy. You just castrate the man. I know it's a little bit hard. I had a doctor say, man, you can just take a shot for that. And I said, no. I said, if somebody, you know, rapes or hurts or whatever, I said, you castrate them and then we know who they were.
Yeah.
But they don't want to do that. They're not serious about stopping it, because all it would take was one time of doing it and proving that you're going to do it. And then maybe one more time and guys will finally wake up about, no, that's not cool.
Yeah.
But they're not really, it's not really trying to fix anything.
I hear you. Hey, hate to do this to you, but it is a call-in show. We do have to take some other things. Any shout-outs before I send you away?
Well, I was going to tell Miss Perrin one more thing. Dobie Gillis, first season, first scene.
Dobie Gillis?
Dobie Gillis.
That would predate Karen by a lot, but go ahead.
The reason I said that, you were talking with somebody about the Mandela, you know, things changing. Again, if it does happen, I'm not saying it does, it all has to fit into where we're living now.
Oh, yeah.
But anyway, first scene, first thing, is that the same as it used to be? Or because that was 1954, maybe? Long time ago. But anyway, y'all have a good day. I'm out.
All right. Thanks, man. See ya.
Later.
You know, that reminds me, by the way, of an email that I got.
I forgot to read it, which was
I sent you the Gilligan's Island flat earth reference.
Yeah.
All right. So this is for you guys out there. If you remember all the Gilligan's Island episodes, and you probably should, this is from season 3, episode 3, which was called Please Pass the Vegetables, right? So this guy writes me and he goes, Mark, I remember an episode where the castaways found some seeds that had been tainted by uranium. So they planted the seeds and everyone ate their favorite vegetables. Mrs. Howell ate beets and had extraordinary high energy. Gilligan ate spinach, had super strength, and Marianne ate carrots, which gave her super vision. So she looked at the water, at the horizon, and saw a ship well beyond the horizon. She gave great detail describing the boat and the passengers, even saying what they were wearing. And the professor and skipper couldn't see the ship. But inadvertently, there she was. She had HD camera eyes, and she could see the boat off in the distance.
Yeah, that was a funny clip.
And of course you would have written that in, because the curvature of the Earth, why would you have written that in that episode, which would have been 1966?
Especially because the whole point is them being on an island and they're looking for a ship to signal to get off the island.
Right. So if you guys want to have some fun, you can look it up. The clips on YouTube, just look up Please Pass the Vegetables or Please Pass the Vegetables, Marianne. It's a great scene where she just, you're standing there looking off in the distance saying, oh yeah, there's the boat right there.
Mm-hmm.
Very nice. Very nice. So good catch by whoever sent it to me, if it was John. There were multiple people though that caught it at the same time, which was weird. So all right, let's pick up some more calls. I think I already picked up Phoenix. I already picked up that Phoenix one, right? The one, yeah. They called back, right? All right, so let's
I don't know.
Oh, I think we already picked that person up. But we know what we're going to do. Oh yeah. You know what? I'm going to bring this up, by the way. I gotta bring this up. So No Despair Bear, this is something that always bugged me. I'm kind of funny about media. So this is a Gilligan's Island thing. The very early, when, you know, Gilligan's Island was one of those shows that transitioned from the black and white era to the color era, right? And like Bewitched, and, you know, like, so like a season or two was in black and white and they switched over to color when more people were buying color TVs. The early, if you guys remember the Gilligan's Island theme song, at the very end, it was like, you know, the Skipper 2, the millionaire and his wife, the movie star, and the rest. This isn't a Mandela effect thing, right? They actually said, and the rest. Well, the show became very popular, and there was only two other characters, which were the professor and Marianne. And they're like, what the hell? We're the rest? There's only, you know, how the hell do you lump two people? You call them and the rest. So they rewrote the end of the song to say the professor and Marianne, which is actually very catchy.
Mm-hmm.
They got their credit where credit is due. It's like, yeah, there was only seven castaways. It's like, well, how lazy was it? It's like, oh yeah, the movie star. It's like, who's the rest? Who cares? Who cares about the professor and Marianne? Just saying, the rest, those other people we don't care about. Talk about, they're in every single freaking episode. Whatever. Of course, I'm naive. I didn't know why they called her Ginger until color television, and way later, because I didn't know that Ginger was another term for red hair.
That's right. You told me that before.
Yep. That's what, yeah, sad. Okay, let's pick up, let's do Ontario, Canada. All right, Canada, what's happening?
Hey, what's going on? Wow, this is amazing.
Why is it amazing?
Can you guys hear me now?
Well, we could always hear you.
Sorry, I had to change it into the headphones so I wouldn't mess up with your audio. First of all, I just want to say thank you from Ontario, Canada, with all the work you guys have been doing, just for, I guess, flat earth-wise, and just people who are just searching for truth in general, or trying to figure out who they are or where they live. And what's going on with the elections? If, I guess, you guys have any updates on what's happening? I have not looked at it at all today.
Yeah, the update is it's all crap, and tomorrow morning it doesn't matter. And next week, who the hell cares? There's like nobody, and then nobody's going to care for two more years. And then it'll be the big discussion, whether will blue team run the really old guy and will red team run Trump again, or will Trump be beaten by DeSantis out of Florida? That I can already tell you, that's what happens 2 years from now. But the midterms...
I guess my question is, what do you think? Is it going to go way too much to the right, where it's like overly, I guess, if you say like overly Christian or religious, where nope. Just see things getting way out of line on that side?
No. The red wave, I can already tell you, I've been looking at it. The red wave is not what you expect. What you probably don't know about American politics is unless you get a full two-thirds majority of the House and the Senate, you don't really get to change anything. It's part of our balances system to where it's, you know, push-pull, but neither side has ever dominated. And that domination...
You have to get both sides, yeah.
You know what I mean? So no. So tomorrow morning, is it going to be a red state? Not to be confused with the movie Red State, directed by Kevin Smith. No, it's not good. It's not going to be that. It's just going to be the red team's going to pick up some more stuff. And I guarantee you blue team's going to pick up some stuff. And it's not going to, I'm sorry. I mean, the people that thought that this big red wave was going to be part of the draining the swamp 2.0, even though 1.0 never happened.
Yeah.
No, nope, nope, nope. Well,
there's no way. I don't trust it either. It can't be because it's always the scale. They're playing the scales. One side balances the other, and the other side balances the other. But
yeah. Yeah. And plus blue team runs the White House right now. So what are you going to do? I mean, even if red team dominated, just dominate across the board, where are you going to, pull Biden out of the White House? No. No, of course not. I mean, Trump was impeached several times. They didn't pull him out. They tried since the beginning.
Yeah.
So it's tough to impeach somebody. We got to remember the last person that successfully was thrown out was Nixon. And that's saying something because, you know, he was caught with it, you know, literally with his hand in the cookie jar type thing. And he resigned before they got a chance to throw him out. So whatever.
What do you think is going to change this whole thing? I guess, I don't know if that change is the right word or just what's going to change people's minds or how are we going to, I guess change is the only word I can use right now. How are we going to change people's minds? Or are we able to wake people up, or is it just we just let it go the way it's supposed to go? You know, it just you do what individually each of us do.
Think about this. Think about the numbers we've accomplished just in the last 7 years. Right, 7 years ago we weren't nearly. I mean, it was just a small. Small group of people that were just spreading the word. And now, you know, we've had conferences. Heck, again, before the pandemic, we had conferences all over the place. Couldn't keep track of all the meetups. And I mean, yes, the blue dots are getting more and more and more and more. So don't sweat it. I mean, yes, there's a huge amount of NPCs out there, but because of people like Karen and people like David and Jaron and Bob and Kemi and you know, all the core conference speakers and all the people that go out there and spread the word, we've been doing amazing work. You can't get them all, though. Can't. I mean, seriously, I'd be disappointed if we did. It is not an easy slog at all. And the thing that's our weakness is also our strength, which I said during the conference, which was we don't have any high profile trolls that are dedicated against us. Yeah, we got a couple of channels, sure, but nobody in mainstream that's like on a crusade to wipe us out. That would help us out more than anything. So we take a lot of numbers quietly by attrition. So don't sweat it. Every day I wake up, I get emails and texts and phone calls from people. It's like, oh yeah, you woke me up. Or, you know, they list all the content. And I love for the fact that even now I get stuff sent to me that was, you know, that was part of stuff that I did. They don't know it has anything tied to me at all. So anyway, I'm rambling. Anything else?
If I may just ask, I guess one more question is, I don't know if that has happened to like a lot of other people as well, but from my perspective, you know, just once I guess I start going through the rabbit hole, I guess it was part of me since I was just really young itself. I always try to question everything, you know, I try to go follow my heart. And then when I saw things didn't line up, I was kind of like curious, like why is it this way? When the people, you know, you sit in church and you hear people talking and then next thing people go out of the church, Sunday's over and everybody changes their complete mindset. And then, you know, the pastors would talk completely differently. And, you know, right, I guess the point is once I went down the rabbit hole, I went so far that, you know, I guess you can get sometimes lost and to a point where you get into this void where you might get too far and you just kind of lose track almost of life, you know, like what am I supposed to do or where am I supposed to go? Like, I guess you get back to this beginning part and then, I don't know, is that like a bad thing or is just you kind of just looking around and just...
No. I mean, everybody's path is slightly different. Everybody's journey. And so, you know, just because there's tons of people, they get really, really jazzed up and their enthusiasm is through the roof and then they fall off and, you know, start doing other things. But there's a reason why we have a 99% retention rate. Seriously, find me a group of people that was into Flat Earth that aren't into it anymore. Oh yeah, they may be going off and doing their own thing and doing their own lives, but they always circle back. I ran into tons of people at the conference that's like, oh yeah, where have you been? What have you been doing? It's like, oh, I've been around. You know, Flat Earth's always been there. They, again, it's the red pill, blue pill thing. So don't worry. I mean, you don't have to be, look, just because you're not making content on a regular basis or, you know, holding up the torch as high as you can doesn't mean that you're not contributing to the cause. You absolutely are. You're calling, you're talking to me right now. You're influencing people just by talking to me right this second.
That is awesome, yeah. You know what? I know what it is. I'm sorry. I haven't got the Karen B stuff yet, and she has so much information. So I will get to your stuff, Karen. I know I will. You are on my radar, and I will get there.
Awesome.
Awesome. Really, really great. Now go blow up something in our name.
I appreciate it for everything.
Thank you.
All right. Have a good one.
All right. Bye-bye. See you, man. And he was gone. So, yeah, you know what? Let's bring him in. Ready? Here we go. Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it with True Snacks.
New York, New York, with my vagabond shoes.
Longing to stray.
Yeah, sorry.
What's happening, man?
New York today. Not much. New York sucks.
Did you go out and vote today, Zulu?
Abso-fucking-lutely not. I will not participate in that garbage. People are fucking retards to have any kind of animosity towards each other over, oh, you're a Trump supporter, you're a Biden supporter. No, you're both fucking morons because it's not real. Doesn't matter who the fuck is up there. They're going to just do whatever the fuck they're going to do. For all eternity, since as long as I've been alive, which is 100,000 fucking years, they lie to you. They all do. They all promise. I won't come in your mouth. I promise I won't. As soon as they get in office, it doesn't matter which one. They blow their load in your fucking mouth. Fuck them. It's stupid. I'm sick of hearing about it. Hey, what's up, guys? Hi, Karen. Hi, Mark.
Hi.
were you watching a Brazzers channel before you came on tonight?
No. They get me so fucking bent out of shape. I'm just so sick of it. It's everywhere. Everybody, you know, Trump 24. Just idiot.
The good news is after
thing they throw in your face.
Is after tonight, you won't have to really hear much about it until we get to literally, you know, the beginning
until
of
the next one.
Again, provided nothing happens, and right now it doesn't look like anything's going to happen. Blue team's got to pick somebody because they're not going to pick Biden again. They wouldn't be that dumb. And then red team has a big decision because
it could be. I mean,
I don't know. He'd be the oldest
to have up there because that's the biggest distraction in the world. Nobody talks about any of the policies or Kamala Cunt Harris. Nothing. Everybody talks about this guy's fucking Alzheimer's. That's it. So they do whatever they want behind the scenes.
So turn it into more of a distraction. I don't know. If I was a handler, I don't think I'd push him up because he would be Peanut. How old would he be in 24? Would he be 80? He'd be 137, right? Something like that.
I don't know.
He'd be old.
Something like that. You talk to the guy who invented insulin, motherfucker. He's so stupid.
I knew Lincoln. Yeah.
I knew it. And he ain't black. He didn't vote
for me. He ain't black. Nice. Yeah. But anyway, yeah, no, tomorrow morning, we'll see the fallout and there'll be, oh, this state cheated and this county cheated and this city cheated. But both red team and blue team are going to be pointing fingers and no one's going to care.
Right. There's another thing for distraction, for division. Division. Everything is always red and blue, and they just add so many red and blues, so many things that are red and blue.
Yeah.
Ridiculous.
Very true.
Ridiculous. You know? Yeah. Like that Artemis thing, that's not going to happen. That'll never happen.
They've already pushed it forward. I think they pushed it forward like six times already. So, yeah, blow it up on the pad. Which is, why not? Oh, he's 80. He would be 81. Yeah, Biden would be 81 if he wanted to run again.
81. I believe there's only one president in history that has won two terms, but not consecutive. I believe it's only one. Grover Cleveland. And I think for the show, Trunk 2024, he'll be number two. He'll be the second one to ever do it.
Possibly. If I was red team, I'd probably, you know, work DeSantis in as a VP. Then you'd have both on the same ticket. Mm-hmm. You'd have Trump and DeSantis.
Right, that'd be a good show.
Yeah, and then see what blue team
boils down to what Carlin said, even as far back as the 50s, it's all the illusion of choice.
Right.
It's going to be whatever it's going to be. You just pretend and you feel happy inside.
Right.
Grow the fuck up. What the fuck is wrong with people? Oh, sorry. I'm just so annoyed.
There's a lot of followers out there, Zulu. A lot.
Yeah. I mean, it's one thing at your local level and the mayor and that. And even that is corrupt at the point of nepotism. Because you know Grandpa Joe is fucking bringing in his kid as the fucking new mayor, not you. So, I mean, it's just all ridiculous that we even have that. And, you know, I'm sorry. And actually, I did have a question, though, about street cred. Because didn't you tell me that the women's staff, they had to work in their bra and panties when they were doing the fireworks?
No. That was my meth lab.
That was the meth lab.
Yeah. We can't have employees walking out with product, man. You know, you got to keep your pimp hand strong on something like that.
No,
I didn't care what they did. I mean, I just drove stuff around campus, supplies around campus, and had them keep their own time cards, right. And they were very honest about it, which was great. It was honest. I mean, now again, because we weren't dealing with drugs, a lot easier to trust people. You know, if I was having people tie up cocaine
in little
baggies, that would have been tough.
Right. You could tell, boy, there's a lot of blockbusters exploding on that side of the campus.
Yeah. Again, that's another reason why you don't hire a lot of guys to do it, especially with and I was the only one that dealt with the finished product. But anyway, hey, we gotta run this thing out because I think we ran late during one of the breaks.
I got a quote. All right. You've got to try and take things to the next level or you'll just get stuck in a rut.
Cool.
I'm doing it over and over and over. And that was, you'll never guess who it was.
I do not know.
John Michael Osborne. You know who that is?
Who is it?
Ozzy, mate.
Oh, I see. I didn't know Ozzy's full name.
I didn't know his name. Never knew his first name was John, or his middle name for that matter. I had no idea. I mean, I knew he wasn't born Ozzy, but
yeah, of course.
I didn't know what it was?
No, that sounds like quite a nice British name. Sure.
Right.
Very cool.
Too funny.
All right, man. Well. I think we successfully made it through an election evening.
Shout out to
go ahead.
Young Willie or something. I don't know. That's it. Go ahead. And you guys. Shout out to you guys. Sorry.
We will be back next week. Same flat time. Same flat channel. We'll have to see what happens tomorrow morning. You know, I will be watching the news, so I'll be up to speed next week, although I'm probably not going to talk about it. Say goodnight, Karen.
Good night, Karen.
Say goodnight, Zulu.
Good night, Zulu.
Peanut just waves his cigarette in the distance. And let's take us to that final music, shall we?
I guess we shall.
Okay. Oh, and hot sex.
All right.
Good night, everybody.
ever been. And I'm so tired of being on the ropes again. That's the lovely girl standing on the moon.
Love so much.